Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Today we are going to learn about how to write the equations or mathematics in the LaTeX. So basically what I will start with, first I will give some motivation or some feeling that what we want to write, what kind of math we want to understand, which we want to write in the LaTeX. Then I will introduce you with some of the package which I think we should put in the preamble so that we do not get the error while writing the equations. Then I will introduce you with the two type of the math mode, and then different type of the environment, delimiters, how to write the array and matrices, how to write the theorems, and many other things, some small things like putting the square root, bracket, integral signs, differential, etc., etc., right? So we will go step by step. So what we want to write actually, so I am first, before going to start with the main content, I am just giving you some examples of some equations which we would like to understand that how we can write those equations. So for example, here, this equation, if you see equation number one, this is just a single equation. And so we want to understand how we can write a single equation, how we can write if we have an equation which is written in the multiple lines, or how we can write some mathematical formula which is written in the inline mode. Or but I will explain what it means by this word inline. So what is the meaning that suppose you are writing some paragraph, for example, as you did yesterday in the assignment, you were writing some paras, but suppose in that para, if you want to write some mathematical formula, then how we can do, how we can write that mathematical expression. Similarly, we will try to understand this thing, how we can write these matrices, or how we can write these kind of equations where we have the braces on upper side or lower side, how we can write, for example, if you look into this last equation, you have the bar here, which is quite long in the height. So how we can write these kind of things, okay? Similarly, these are some more examples which we would like to understand today. Some integrals, some fractions, some summation signs, or look at this equation, which is, this is just one single equation and what it covers so many lines. So we would like to understand how we can write all these things. Okay, so that is the motivation of our present lecture or today's lecture, that we want to understand how we can write the mathematics in the using the LaTeX. Okay, now what is the first thing we need to know when we are going to write the mathematics in the LaTeX? So first thing which you should do actually, which I will explain later on also, is some list of the packages. So yesterday you have learned that while writing any document in the LaTeX, we start with first line in which we define the class of our document. For example, yesterday you wrote that document class, then in this curly bracket you wrote article, so you were writing an article. And after that, what has been told yesterday, that you have to write begin document and end document, and before that there is something here you can give the information of your package, what package you need to write here. Okay, for example, if you are writing the mathematical equations in the LaTeX, then you need, so for example, here I have listed one package, use package AMS Math, then use package AMS Symbol, Fonts, SI Units. So it is not that we need all these packages to write any equation, but sometime we need, if you are writing, for example, some physical quantity, and if you want to write units of the, for example, if you're writing, say, acceleration due to gravity, 9 meter per second square, then, and if you want to write that unit in some very good style, for example, then you need to, you can use actually this package. Similarly, I will let you know some of the mathematics here. We may need this math tool. So what is my advice? That whenever you are writing any LaTeX document, and if you know that, okay, I have to use the mathematics in, I have to write the mathematical equation, then try to write all these packages in the your preamble, okay? So that while writing your document, you do not get any error, okay? Otherwise, if you get the error, then also don't worry. You will be able to know, I think sometime from error also we got to know that what package we need, or even, and if these packages are not installed, then also your LaTeX will ask you to install those packages. And if your laptop is connected to the, or computer is connected to the internet, then that package will be installed. Okay, so this is just an advice that while writing the mathematics, put these few lines in your preamble. Okay, so first I would like to introduce with you the two type of mode in the LaTeX. Okay, one is called this test mode, and other is called math mode. So what you did yesterday while writing some paragraph or some sections, whatever you was doing, that is called the test mode. Here you was writing simple text. Okay, for example, I am here in the LaTeX pose, I have written here, test is written as is, some, these kind of lines basically. That is simply called our test mode. But if you want to write the mathematics, okay, some formula, some equation, then you need the math mode. Okay, so what we have to deal with, what we have to understand, that how to write the mathematical equation or formula, and for that, we will be writing the things in the math mode. Now, what is the difference between this math mode and test mode? For example, look at this equation. This, what I have written, AX is equal to B on right-hand side and on left-hand side. Now, here, the way you have, you did yesterday, you just write in your that paragraph, just AX is equal to B. So that is simply a test mode. But if you write in the math mode, then what will happen that your mathematical symbol, they will come in the italic form, okay? That is the one thing, that when we write some mathematics, then that generally comes in the italic form. And second thing is that when we are writing something in the math mode, then the spacing between the letters, that will not come there, okay? For example, here I have written Einstein mass relation. Okay, so this is written simply, I will let you know that how to write, how we will write the in the math mode, but these are just the example that what will happen if you write Einstein mass and relation, these three words in the math mode. Okay, so what will happen? This side I have just written in the test mode. So you are able to distinguish Einstein, then we have mass, and then we have relation. But if you write in the math mode, then the spacing between Einstein and mass and relation, that spacing will not be there. Okay. So what happens in the math mode, the spacing between the letters, and that will not be coming there. Okay. So that is the difference between the test mode and math mode. Okay, so now the math mode, they are of generally two types, okay? So what is the meaning of that? So I have written here two things. One, I have written inline mode, and second thing, I have written display math mode. Okay, so what is the meaning of these two things? Now, just let me show you one document actually to understand, to get a feeling. Look at this one. Look at this document. Okay, I have written here this first you have some equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Then in the next line I have written this b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. And then so you are able to see two things. One is that I have written some math in the line, and one is that where I have written the math as a separate environment. Okay, means as a we are not writing the mathematics in the line. So whenever we are writing some formula in the line, okay, then that is called the inline mode, or that is also called the ordinary mode. And when we want that our equation or math that display separately, so that we could number that. So if you want to say that, okay, this is my equation one, this is my equation two, and maybe later on you want to call that equation, you want to refer to that equation. For example, you will see that, okay, in equation one, I have written a quadratic equation whose root. Okay, I think someone has, please mute your microphones.
Yeah, Mr. Jiten. Mr. Jiten Thakur. Can you please mute your mic, Mr. Jiten?
Okay. So what I was talking about, that we will deal with two kind of situations. One, then we want to write our mathematical formula in orderly, along with orderly test or in a paragraph. So that I will call the inline mode. And second thing, when I want to display my mathematics as a separate equation. Okay, so that is called the display mode. So we will be writing the mathematics in these two kind of thing. One is called the ordinary mode or inline mode, whereby my formula, for example, here I have written a line Einstein mass energy relationship E is equal to mc square. So this Einstein mass energy relationship, this is a test mode. But along with that, I have written a mathematical formula. So that is coming in the same line, and I will call this inline mode. Okay, but this is a math mode. Okay, and rest of the things, they are the test mode. And in this display math mode, what I have done, solve the quadratic equation that is written separately. But the equation which I want to write, that I have written, that I have displayed as a separate, in a separate environment or at a separate line. So I will explain how we will write all these things. So at this point, I just want to tell you that we will be dealing with these two kind of mode. One is called inline mode and another is called the math mode. So first I will explain how we can write inline mode. For example, what I wrote on what I have written this line, Einstein mass energy relationship E is equal to mc square. So how to write this formula E is equal to mc square? Okay, so let us look at this, what you have to write in the LaTeX. So two things are there. One is one is math mode and another is test mode. So when you have to switch from the test mode to the math mode, then you have to tell the LaTeX that, okay, now I want to write some mathematical formula, and the, now I have to switch the math mode. For example, here you have start writing Einstein mass energy relationship, and then suddenly you want to write some mathematical formula. Then you have to tell to the LaTeX. So how we can tell that now we are going to write some mathematical formula in the inline mode? So for that, in the LaTeX, there are different facilities, but I will emphasize that whether we use one or other facility, all will give the same result. Okay, so I will be using only one, and that is here the dollar symbol. Okay, so what we will do, whenever we are writing some mathematical formula in the line, so before starting to write that mathematical formula, for example, E is equal to, I have to put this dollar symbol there. And then I have to write my mathematical expression. For example, E is equal to MC squares. So C square, for the square, I have this superscript, I have used this cap. I will explain the superscript, subscript later on in detail. So at the present, I just want to tell you that if you have to write the formula in the inline mode, then what you will do, you will start with a dollar sign. Then you will write here your mathematical formula. And then you, when you are end up with your mathematical formula, you have written E is equal to MC square. Then you have to close that math mode. Okay, so that next you could start with the rest of the test. Okay, so this is how you can write inline mode. You can also use these facility slash close brackets, opening bracket and close bracket. So let us focus only on one thing. Okay, so so we will be using this. Okay. E is equal to MC square, and on the both side I have put here dollar sign. For example, what I told you on the last slide, that when I will write Einstein mass energy relationship, Einstein mass relation, okay, in the math mode. Okay, so what I have done, I have written dollar in the beginning and at the end, and because of that, this Einstein mass relation, that space is not coming there. So you have to take care of that. If you are writing the test, then by mistake, if you put the dollars on both sides, then you will be not able to get that spacing, and properly your test will not appear. Okay, whereas in the simple test, you will be writing simple Einstein mass relation. Okay, so I hope you have understood that how we can write the mathematics. So let me give you feel actually. For example, look at this. What I have done here, what you did yesterday, the assignment, after that I just started a section, and in that section I am just writing one line. What I have written there, the equation E is equal to MC square. Now look at this. Okay, so if I for example, if I forget to add this dollar sign, and if I compile my document, then here I am getting the error that missing dollar sign. Okay, so you, if you are starting some math environment, then you have to close that math environment even in the inline mode. Okay, so that is one important thing. One is that, suppose, now look at what I told you, that suppose you are writing just E is equal to MC. Okay, suppose you have some formula E is equal to MC, and you are writing in the math mode. Now look at this, how this EMC is appearing. E is equal to MC, that is appearing in the italic form. Okay, and if I remove these both dollars, then it will be a test mode. And if you again compile this, now look at this E is equal to MC. Now it is not in the italic form. Okay, so that is the difference. Means whenever we are writing some mathematics, then generally that will come in the italic form, and the spacing is also will not be there. And if you, so what is the conclusion so far, that we have the two type of the math mode. One is the inline mode, and other is the display math mode, and we have understood.
Yeah, I think that we can also tell them that if we remove the space between E and equal to sign, and equal to sign and MC, then also in the math mode, that those spaces will be added automatically. So I think maybe we can show that.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so let us go back to this equation again. Suppose I have written that E is equal to MC square again. Okay, and let us compile this. And look at this, E is equal to MC square. So there is the space between E, between the, on the both side of equal sign. Now what Avinav sir is saying, so let us compile it again. So you can see that here in the LaTeX, I haven't put any space, but when I am compiling this, and then you can see that again there is the space on both side of your equal sign. That is what he want to convey. Okay, so I hope this is clear that in the inline mode, we will just put dollar sign on both side, and in between that, we will write our mathematical formula. Okay, that may be a complicated formula that we will explain later. So this is just to. So these are some other way what I have written, but if you stick to the one, that is okay. Now let us move to the next thing. So now what I want to tell you that how to write the mathematics in the display mode, so that suppose you have some mathematical expression which is large, okay, if you have an equation which is covering your whole line, or if you have a multiple line equation or multiple equations, okay, so for that you have to then you should avoid that inline mode, and you should switch to the display math mode. So in the display math mode, now your mathematics, as I told you, that will not come in that particular test line or paragraph, but it will be displayed separately on your page. So if you want to write, so I will start with very simple thing, okay, just single equation. Suppose you want to write just one line equation. So for that, so as we did earlier, for the inline mode, we have to use the math environment. So for that, I was using a dollar symbol on both side. If you want to write some equation, then you have to switch to the, you have to use this environment. So what is written here? Let us understand. First, I have written begin equation. And if you are, so with the help of begin equation, I am starting some math environment in the display mode. So if I am starting some environment, for example, begin equation here, then I have to end that environment so that after writing this equation, I could again write my some other test or paragraph. So if I am writing the begin equation, then correspondingly there will be end equation. And within this begin equation and end equation, here, for example, you can write your mathematical expressions. And here I have used some word that is called label and key. I will explain this in just a few minutes. So that is, that will help us to refer this equation in the document. So I will explain in detail what is the meaning of label, key, all that. So at the moment, let us try to understand that if we want to write a single equation, for example, look at this equation. I have written here x square plus 2 lambda plus sine of x is equal to 0. Okay, so what I have written? Okay, this and this, because in this slides, I have written earlier many equations. So here equation 7 is coming, okay? If this is the first equation of your document, then equation 1 will come there, okay? So numbering will come automatically. You need not to worry about that, okay? And you can avoid the numbering also. That also I will explain. So let us concentrate on how to write this equation. So what I told you, when you are going to write some equation in the display mode, so you have to start with begin equation. Then you have to write your equation. So for example, here x square plus 2 plus this lambda. For the this lambda, I use this command. So in a moment, I will explain. From here, we can pick all these commands. For the lambda, I have written slash lambda. Then for the sine of x, so I have written for the, although if you write simply sine, then also it will work. But it is good to use this command for the trigonometric, so that I will explain. So at the moment, just the motive is to understand how to write a equation, okay, a single equation. For the single equation, if you want to write an equation which will take only one line of your document, then you can use this begin equation, end equation, environment. Okay, and between this begin equation and equation, you will write your equation. So again, let me because I will not again and again switch to this text studio, but this is just the beginning. So to give you some feeling of what we are going, we are doing. So see at this point. So look at this. Oh, I have written an equation. For example, here I have this equation x is equal to minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac over 2a. So what I have done, I have written begin equation, and then I have written end equation, and between that equation I have written my mathematical formula. So rest of the ingredients, how to write the square root fraction, that will be explained later. But this is just to tell you that just after your para, wherever you want to write your equation, just, and if you want to number that equation, if you want to write a single equation, just start with begin equation, write your formula or whatever you equation you have, and then end that. Okay, and along with that you can use the label, etc. So now I will explain what is the meaning of label. Okay, so see, what I have written here. I have written begin equation, then equation. After that, I have written this line label, and inside the bracket, I have written here EQ dot single one. Okay, so this is just, since I have written here the equation. So here inside the bracket, we have a key. Key means, with the help of this name, we can refer to this equation later on in the document. For example, here I have written a quadratic equation, and later on you want to say that in equation 7, I have written a quadratic equation whose roots are this. Then you need not to write there in equation, then you need not to write there 7 number auto manually. Okay, it will come automatically. And if you want that it comes automatically in your test somewhere, then you have to use this this key basically. So let us see how to use this label. See here. Suppose after writing that particular equation, which I showed you on the last slide, in your LaTeX document, you are writing this line. We have to find the roots of equation 7. Which may be real or imaginary. Equation 7 is a quadratic. Equation 7 is quadratic in nature. Then how you will do in the LaTeX? So in the LaTeX, what you will do, you will write, we have to find the roots of, then equation 7, this thing. In place of this, what I have used here, look at this. I have written slash, C ref, then inside this curly bracket, I have written here something. Now, what is that? This is the key I defined in this last equation, the equation to which I want to refer EQ, then single one. So, I have at this point one advice that at this point, at this place, in place of key, you can write any word which is not repeating in your document, but it is very, because you must be using equations, then you will be using tables, sections, etc., etc., and you can refer to the table also, you can refer to the figures also. So when we are giving the label to something, then start with, for example, if we are referring to the equation, then start the key like EQ underscore or EQ column. If you are referring to the table, then start with the table underscore, like that. Give some meaningful name so that you could understand from that word that, okay, you are referring to the equation, or you are referring to the table, or you are referring to the figure. Okay, so that is just for your convenience, that that will help you to understand what you have written. So let us try to understand what is the, how these things are coming. So, okay, so look at this. What I have here, Equation 7. In place of equation 7, I have written slash CREF. Then in the curly bracket, I have written that key. Now yesterday, Dr. Sunil and Avinav, they told you that if you want to refer to something, then you can use reference slash ref or EQREF or VREF. So what I am using here, we can also use all those style or commands to refer to some equation. But here I am introducing you with one new thing, which I think we haven't studied earlier in this workshop, that is called the CREF package or CREF. So for that, we will use this package, CLEVER-EFC, okay, CLEVREF, you can say. So if you want to use this, command CREF, then you will put this use package CLEVREF in your preamble. Okay, only then it will work. Okay, and one advice is that when you are writing your package in the preamble, then put use package CLEVER at the end of the list of those package at the last. Okay. So how the things are working? Let us see. So what I have here, I have written here slash CREF, and then in the curly bracket I have written key. And when you compile that, this word EQ dot, that is the speciality of this package, that it will come automatically. If you are using the package REF, if you are using this REF command and inside the curly bracket you are writing that key, then there will appear just a root of 7. Then you have to write manually EQ, or otherwise you have to use some EQ ref kind of thing. But with the help of this CREF, so just write CREF, and in the curly bracket, just type your key and it will automatically give you EQ dot and inside 7. Okay. So this, and look at this line here. What is happening here? I have started some new. So here I have the full stop. Then I am starting with some new line, say, or so what you have here, equation 7. Now here I we have EQ dot, and here my capital E and full equation. So what is the specialty of this package? So when you want something in the capital and the full, then write slash CREF. So obviously when you are starting some new line, then you want to start with a capital letter. Okay. So when you have to start, you want to write a capital letter, then write C, capital C, and then rest of things, small REF, and inside that write key. Now you can use CREF or capital CREF for the equations, for the tables, for the section. For example, suppose tomorrow we will discuss the figures also, and then if you have some figure in the document and you will say that, okay, in figure one, we have explained this one. So while writing that line in figure one, then you will just write slash CREF, and inside that put your label key, what you have used for the figure, and it will automatically produce your fig dot 7. It will automatically understand that, okay, now you are referring to the equation, or you are referring to the figure, etc. Okay, so I will advise you, although it is your choice that what you want to use, ref or EQ ref or CREF, but you can use this CREF, or, and if you want to use this, then don't forget to write this use package CLEVREF in the preamble. Okay, so this is what is the meaning of the label key, that with the help of that you can refer to your that equation in the test. Okay,
Arvind sir, here in single, after single we are using one. So that one also has some meaning, no, or that no, is no, essential?
No. I started with, so this is your choice what you want to write here. Okay, okay. I can write here a single, I can write here QQAD, or whatever you want to write, RA, whatever. So this is a key basically, but you should not repeat, avoid to repeating. And I have written here EQ dot, just to understand fine, that fine. I am referring to.
Fine. I was just interested to know, like, one is
sorry. Doesn't have any specific... to interrupt you. Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Sir, how that equation number 7, the mark point 7 is coming out in the output, na?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sir, how that 7 thing is coming?
So it is, you see.
The output, please.
You see.
Yes, 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 yes. I mean, here is the input code, but here you have not written, I mean, 7 yet, but still in the right side of the bracket of the output, there is 7, right?
Yeah, because in my this document, but I am showing you, my this equation is equation number 7. Okay?
Here's the thing, I mean, I am asking you, you have not written anywhere in the input that this is the equation number 7. But how the, system is getting that, okay, it is equation
yeah,
number 7?
It is, yeah, it is automatically that what I told, EQ dot, okay? So it is coming automatically.
Okay, okay, sir, basically in econometrics, I mean, often this is happening for me, especially when I'm writing papers for the international NGOs, okay? Mm-hmm. It is not only the simple equation number, I need to include the chapter number as well. Sometimes, it actually gets like that, okay, 7.2 equation number 7.3 or 7.1.2, this sort of number does come. Are you getting my point, sir?
Yes, yes, yes.
So how all to those, do that?
All those kind of things, they can be handled with this app. We will come to the point where we'll be referring to some equation 7.1 or 7.1 A, B, C, like that, okay?
So yes, what sir, yes, sir.
You have to just write your key inside and it will automatically write your EQ dot. You need not to worry about EQ dot. If you are
key means, would you please be kind to go to the key again?
Yeah,
the
yeah.
Network connectivity, I have been able to go through that. Sorry.
Yeah, this label.
Okay.
And then in the curly bracket, you have to write your key. Just write that key after the C ref in the curly bracket. And it will automatically understood that now you are referring to the equation. So we have to write EQ. LaTeX will write EQ dot. If suppose you are using this label, suppose you are writing some figure environment, and then you are writing this label, even though there you are writing same key, then it will, but don't use same key for different things, but any key there you are using, then it will write the fig dot, fig 7, fig 8, fig 9 kind of thing. Okay, so you need, that is what I told you with that, with this CREF package or CREF package, what you can do, you just give your key and it will automatically produce whether you are referring to the equation or whether you are referring to the section or chapter or what you are referring to. Okay, you need not to worry about that. Okay, only the thing you have to take care of that you have to put this use package clever ref in your preamble.
Okay. CREF package is basically this. This clever ref package, right, sir?
Yeah, clever, yes, yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Sorry for disturbing, sir.
Sir, for a different equation, if I want to refer some other equation, like equation 8, again, so then I will have to give a different key?
Yes, yes. For every equation, you have different key.
Okay. So that I can choose on my own?
Yes, you can choose at your own.
This might not be a right point to talk right now. But would you please be kind to go to the text studio to write down the equation so that we can understand it quite well?
Okay, let me see at this point. Okay.
Okay.
So what I told you that earlier I have written this equation. Okay. I haven't written any key. Okay. Now suppose that in the
compile it so that I mean we can find it out. Please.
Okay. Yeah. I have compiled it. So this is on the other side. You are getting equation one for
number
this
one.
Is your okay. This is first equation of this document. This is just the document you created yesterday. Okay, so you can see that there is no equation anywhere. This is the first equation, so it is giving equation one. So this is equation number. Okay, don't confuse with our other things. okay, or let me basically.
So Arvind sir, if we want the number to be 1.1, how we can do that?
Yes, that I will explain actually. Okay, yeah, I will explain that. Okay. Okay. So what is the point? So now what I suppose after this equation, now I am writing that, okay, in now I want to in, so I am not writing here anything, sir. Here I want to write like, okay, in equation, I am writing here manually.
Puranji, I think I have kindly mute your mic. Puranji.
Okay, so I am writing here in equation one, expression of formula of quadratic, whatever formula of something is written, right? So this is just some test, and here I have no. Here I want that it appear automatically. So what I have to do, I have to write label C ref. Okay, then in the curly bracket now I have to write the key. For that key I have to go here. I have to write label, and then I have to define here key P Q. Any key you can give. Okay, I am not writing for the moment. Any key F G H. So I am writing here F H. So if you will write some arbitrary thing, then it will be very difficult to handle. Okay, so that is why I always write some meaningful things. Okay, and now I am compiling this. Now you see what I have got. Undefined control sequence in C ref. Now, if I go to my preamble, I haven't written here use package C ref. Clavref. Clavref. Okay. Now I compile it again. Now you can see here after this equation. It is just I am getting in equation. So whatever I have written there. So what I have written, just this line, see this in, then I haven't written here equation one now manually.
Okay, it is excellent really. But sir, if I want to mark that equation number one as 1.1 or 1.8, so then how, I mean, what I have to do?
Yeah, actually, let me answer that question. What is happening is, I think that what you want is that if the equation number is from chapter 3 and if it is equation number 7, you want it to be written as 3.7. Am I right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so that we can do by defining in the preamble that the equation should be named as per the sections or as per the chapter. As you can see, Arvind sir has highlighted that.
No, I am doing that, but you won't. Okay, so, see this, what I have to write in the preamble, I have written this number within equation section. Okay, so okay. Now look at this equation 1.1. Okay, so if you want to number within the sections, then in the preamble, you have to write this number.
Sir, within. Go to the equation again. Let us find out.
Okay.
No. Sir, in the output window.
Yes.
No, sir. Okay.
Right?
Yes, sir. So, excellent. Thank you very much.
Okay, so if we are starting, okay, then again some, for example, suppose now I have some section 2. I wrote it. Maths to anything, okay? And then again, suppose I am copying this equation, but I am writing some different key. Compiling again. Maybe some error file. Okay, I forget to copy this. Now look at this. 2.1. Okay, So now I have written in the preamble that number equation within section. So now everywhere, whenever I am starting with some new section, I will get 2.1, 1.1 kind of thing. Okay, 2.2.
Okay, because it is the new section, right?
Yeah.
New section. Okay, sir. Got it, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay. So I hope it is clear that how we can write a single equation, how we can refer to that single equation in the test. Okay. So now at this point, I want to introduce. So for example, in my last equation, I used this lambda, and for lambda, I wrote the command slash lambda. Okay. So, but there are many this type of the Greek letters, okay, alpha, beta, small, or in the italic or upper Greek letter or italic Greek letter. So, in the text studio, you can look at here, and you can whatever the symbol you want to write, you can click on that, and that corresponding a command will come here. For example, if you want to write epsilon, then this kind of symbol epsilon, that is for that you have to write this command. Okay, so you need not to remember all the commands, but along with that there is one more thing which I want to share with you, that is the K LaTeX formula. So you can download K LaTeX formula from this website. You just write your this K LaTeX in the Google, and you will get the link to download. You need not to download right now or for the today's assignment. You don't need that, but just sharing with you that how it works. So, but it helps you if you because you will not be able to, for example, remember all the commands. So this is a very useful thing. For example, here you can see that Greek letters, for example, just click on the, so you know that, okay, I want to write this kind of symbol new, then just click on that, you will get this command here. And you hear this is compiling also, okay? If you want to write this kind of symbol, even I don't know what is the name of this symbol, but you just click on this and you will get the command for that symbol, okay? So in this K LaTeX, there are many symbols, and you can click on any symbol and you will get the command corresponding to that symbol. For example, if I want this omega in the downward side, that is called moho. So you see, let me remove this first one. Okay, so this is the command. If you want to write, for example, this delta kind of thing or triangle, okay, so this is the command. Okay, so you can use this is a very useful software. Just download this from your this website, K LaTeX website, and you can download this K LaTeX formula, and you can use that to write the commands for different mathematical symbols. Okay, so for example, here I have phi in the regular Greek letter, here I have the phi in the italic form. So all what command now I should use for this or this, that all you can know from there. Okay, next I want to explain you how to write this superscript and subscript. For example, earlier I wrote x square. Now look at this. I have here a11, a22. So I am now explaining some of the ingredient which help us to write some complicated mathematical formula. So whenever you want to write a11, here 11 is appearing in the subscript. So what you have to write, a, then you have to put underscore, then in the curly bracket you have to write this 11. So if, for example, so let me show you the general thing, that whenever you are using or going to write the superscript and subscript, then what you have to do, you have to write your expression, expression mean, for example, here E, in the last slide it was A, then what you want to write in the superscript or subscript, that you should write generally in the curly bracket. Look at these various symbols, for example. In the first IM, I want to write just e raised to power x. Then for that, I have to write just e cap, then x. For the superscript, use this cap sign. And for the subscript, use underscore. Now, if you have only one symbol in the superscript, then it is okay that you are not using the these two curly bracket. But if you have the two symbols in the superscript or subscript, then you have to write your those both symbols in the curly brackets. Okay, so that you have to take care of. For example, look at this e raised to power x y. Then I am writing e cap. Then I am writing curly bracket, and then I am writing x y. If I am writing e raised to power x raised to power y. Hello.
So we only need to put the dollar sign on both the sides.
Sorry, you have to.
So we also need to put dollar sign on both sides.
Yeah. So that depends upon whether you are writing that expression in the display math mode or in the inline mode. So to avoid so that
inline
kind.
Mode.
Inline.
Okay, inline mode we don't need.
Yeah. In if you are writing some. Mathematical expression in the inline mode, for example here, then I have to write the dollar on both side. But if you are using, if I will give you one example, let me give you example for that. Look at this thing. Look at this. This is the equation 8. I have written begin equation and equation. Then I have written this equation. So what I have here, square root of x. So for the square root, you use this slash sqrt, and inside the curly bracket, you write what under what you want under this square root. Okay, so I will explain fraction later on. So then e raised to power xy. So here e raised to power e cap, then xy on both sides. Here I do not need to put the dollar because I am writing this as a separate equation in a display mode. Okay, so that is why I haven't written there on these dollars to avoid that. This is in general that this is some ingredient of some expression. Means if you have a large expression and inside that somewhere you are using some symbol, there you have the subscript or superscript and what you have to write. Okay, so look at this, for example, look at these last two. E raised to power, so one is the superscript and another is the subscript. Okay, so what I have to write, e raised to power x, x is in the superscript, and for the subscript I have y, so underscore y. So it will understood that both x and y, they are the be the superscript and subscript of the e symbol. Okay, and whether you are writing this cap first or underscore first, that will produce the same effect. For example, look at this. Look at this. Zeta raised to power. So in the superscript, I have rho, lambda, and this guy. So zeta. I have written here a line. So it is the inline mode. So I have written here dollar on both side. And inside, I have written this zeta for zeta. The command is slash zeta. Then cap. Then in the curly bracket, I have to write out because there are more than one symbol in the superscript. So you have to start with some curly bracket, and then you are end up with all the symbols which are there in the superscript. Then you are you will close that curly bracket, and then you will put that dollar sign again to come end this math mode. Okay. Now look at this. This is of interest for the people who belongs to especially the chemistry, for example, or nuclear physics. Okay, so these superscript, subscript, they are coming before the symbol. So whenever you have to write something, for example, you used to write the isotopes, for example, okay? So this mass number or atomic number, one is coming on the upper side and another is coming on the downside before that particular letter. Okay, so what you have to do, you write that letter, and before that letter, what you have to write, I have written, so for example, U, and before that letter, you have to use this curly brackets. Okay, if you want something under below means as a subscript, then you have to write that curly bracket, and along with that you have to write this underscore. And if you want to write something in the super, then you have to write this gap, and along with that, so you have to use, this is the way you should write, or this is the way we have to write it basically. For example, look at this U raised U and 235 in the superscript. So what I have written, before U, I have to write this curly bracket, and along with that, I have to put this gap. Okay, if you want just U underscore 92, then you have to use U and then curly bracket, and before that, you have to. So first, going towards the left side, first you have to put the curly bracket, and then along with that, you have to put underscore or cap symbol. So underscore means that will go as a subscript, and cap means that will go as a superscript. For example, if you look at first and the last and first, then I have written here cap first and underscore bracket and other thing later. The both will produce the same effect. Only the thing is that before the symbol, put the curly bracket. Now you want this, whatever you are writing here, you want that as a subscript or superscript, just put underscore or cap. Okay, so that you can use. Okay, for the square root, I already told you, if you want to write something under the square root, then just write SQRT command, and inside the curly bracket, you put the value you want to write. And if you want to put like a cubic root or something else, okay, fifth root, then what this close this square bracket and here order of the square root. So this is optional. If you are not writing anything here, then it means you are just simply writing the square root. Otherwise, if you want to write, if your order of the square root is 5 or 3 or 4, then write that number here in place of order. Then you can also try this nested kind of thing. So order square root, SQRT, first curly bracket, that curly bracket is ending at last. Then next square root, this one, its curly bracket ending here. Then next, ending here, and all that. The way. So you can play with all these things. Start with the simple thing and then make it complicated. Okay, don't start with the complicated and then you will get the errors and it will be very difficult to resolve those. Okay, so
also Arvind, always, sir, yes, this, yeah. Sorry to interrupt. This bracket for order, like we have used this type of bracket, right? So can we use other bracket also, or this is specific? Like we
have to use. These are specially for what is told here.
Fine.
Curly bracket.
For order, I'm saying for this curly bracket, order thing.
No, order this, because this is optional. So I have to put this here. So what is told yesterday, whenever we are writing some optional things, then normally that is written between the square bracket. And something okay. which is important, compulsory, that will be written between the curly bracket.
Fine.
Okay. So let us look at this one more ingredient. So that is the fractions now. How you have to write some formula here, you are using some fraction x upon y, for example, or some last. So look at this command. You can use slash frac command. So what you have to write, slash frac, then two curly bracket. Inside first, you will write the numerator, and then again the curly brackets, and in that you will write the denominator. So like this, slash frac, and in the first curly bracket numerator, and in the next denominator you will get x upon y. There are other commands also, for example dfrac. This is d mean here display. Okay, so you can so you just try with these different things and you will be able to see the difference, okay? And you will get x upon y same. So, and you can look at the how the when you are using d frac or whether you are when you are using the f frac or the last one c frac. So when you have the many number of fractions, and this is something called the continued fraction, then in order that we have a beautiful appearance instead of using this frac. For example, if I want to write this expression, and if I am using the slash frac here, then my appearance of the expression will be like this. If I am using the d frac, then appearance will look like this. And if I am using the c frac, then there will be the proper spacing between this horizontal line and all those things. So accordingly, I am just introducing you with different type of the command which we can use for writing the fractions. And you can use, for example, look at this equation again. Here I have written 4x upon 3y. So wherever I have to use the fraction, I have to write 4x upon 3y. So what I have written, slash frac, then the curly, first curly bracket in which I will write the numerator, and the next two curly bracket in which I will write my denominator. Okay, so this is the way you can use the fraction. Then there is also one is called the t frac. This will produce something very small symbol, so that if you are writing some fraction in a para, so that it can fit in that line. So for that you can use the t frac. So I advise write some simple equation, then keep on adding one. First write your equation, just write a square root, compile that, okay, it is good. Then add a fraction, then add a subscript, then add a superscript, then add three things simultaneously. Okay, similarly, there is one more ingredient which I should say is, if you want to write this fancy kind of symbol, for example, generally in the quantum mechanics or something, people used to write this Lagrangian density and this symbol, then for this kind of symbol, you can use this math scale. Okay, so it will be producing the math symbol, okay, and in this decorative way. So cal here, I have written calligraphy. Okay, so just write this command math cal. So for example, here when I am writing this equation, what I have written here, so what I am writing, I have to write this L. So what I have done, I have written slash math cal, then in the curly bracket I have written this L. Okay, and it will produce me for me this symbol. Then on the other side I have written half, so half is appearing as a separate fraction. So slash frac, two curly bracket, in the first curly bracket one, in the second. Then curly square phi over curly f square. Look at this again, I have the fraction here. In the numerator I have curly square phi, in the denominator I have curly f phi square. So what I have done, slash frac, then first curly brackets, inside that I have to write my numerator. So what is this curly, for this the command is, so this partial derivative, okay, so for the partial derivative the command is slash partial, that is the command which will produce this symbol. Okay, then I want the square of that, then cap square, okay, so superscript, then phi, for phi the command is slash phi. So you need not to, again I am saying that don't worry about the commands, they are given in the Text Studio or in the KLATIC. You can just click on the symbol and you will be able to note that what command should I use. Then in the denominator again I have put these two curly brackets, and then my this partial derivative, then phi square, then similarly rest of the things, half m phi square, phi square, and end equation. Okay, so I hope I am clear up to this point. Okay, so now what I am going to introduce you next, that is how to, so what I have written so far, when I am writing some equation in the display mode, then I was writing begin equation, end equation. And then I was writing that, then if you are then along with that equation, there was appearing some number, for example, equation 7 or 8 or something. If you don't want to write your number for your equation, then what you can do, you can use the unnumbered, for unnumbering the equation, you use the environment equation star. Okay, start with begin equation star and end with end equation star and write that equation. Okay, so that will produce for you an equation which will not be numbered. So no number is appearing here. Okay, so so it means now you have to take care of that. It means if no number is appearing, means you will not use an label key, because there is no number of this equation. So later on, you will not be able to refer to this equation. For example, now you cannot say that, in for example, this is some equation, and you will not say that, okay, in that equation I have written this and this. Okay, so then you should not use this environment. But if you are sure that you will not refer to this equation anywhere in the document, then you can use this environment. So to omit the numbering, you can, so for the single equation, you can use this environment, begin equation star, end equation star, or you can also write this, which I will use later on, no number. If you have written begin equation, end equation, after the equation in the line, write slash no number, then you will get equation without any number. Okay, here slash no tag, then you will get an equation without any number. So you can use, so if you have a single equation, then just use this one. Don't use many things, just begin equation star and equation star. But later on, I will use these commands slash no number for multiple lines. So that is why I am introducing you this slash no number, that can also be used to omit the numbering of some equation. Okay, so there are some other environments also which you can use to a number a equation, but what I introduced with you, they are enough. Okay, so next important thing is that suppose you want to repeat the equation number. For example, suppose you are writing some book or thesis, for example, and in some first chapter you have written some equation, and that equation is 8. Okay, and again in chapter 2 you want either you can refer to that equation 8, or sometime what you want, that if you want to give if you want that your that reader need not to go to the chapter 1 again, then you want to write that equation again in the same chapter. But if now you want that same number as I have given earlier, same equation number appear here for this equation. For example, this is equation 8 I have written earlier. This was the equation 8. So I again want to write the same equation here, same equation I have written, and I want that the number repeats. Okay, so what I can do for that, what I will write here in this, instead of the label, I will write slash tag, and in the curly bracket, I will write slash ref and the key of the equation to which I am referring. Okay, so means which I want to repeat. So look at this equation 8. This is the key label. Here I have labeled it. So this key you have to use here. Here slash tag, and in the two curly bracket just write ref. You can write c ref, you can. So I am giving you this as an exercise, that if you write tag and then inside you write this slash ref, then what will happen here? If you write here slash c ref, then what will happen here? If instead of tag you write tag stat, that then what will happen here? Okay, so though all things you can check, but this is just to tell you that you can repeat the equation with the tag environment or tag facility. Okay, now let us make the things little bit more complicated. So what I have, what we discussed so far, just a single equation. Okay, how to write that single equation, which is coming in one line, how to number that equation, how to unnumber that equation, all these things. Now suppose that you are writing some single equation, but that equation is very large and the equation is going out of the page. Okay, then what you can do? You can, for example, look at this equation 10. This equation is very long and it is going out of the page. Okay, so in place of writing this kind of, writing the equation in this way, you will be happy if you could write this equation in this multiple lines. So what I have done here, I have broken this equation from many places. Okay, so now what we want to understand next, how to write a large equation in the multiple lines, or how, the second thing we want to understand now, how to write the multiple equations, okay, more than one equation simultaneously. Okay, so there are many different ways we can do this, but I will introduce one or two ways. For example, I am not going to, there are different environments available for aligning. So what we have to do, we have to break the equation, and along with that, we have to take care that our that equation which is displaying in the document, that looks beautiful. Okay, for example, look at this. Below the equal sign, I have this plus sign, all are in the same, this vertical column. Okay, so this is called something aligning of the equation. Okay, so there are different environments we can use for writing the multiple equation or a single equation in multiple lines. So I will focus only on this right now, and when I will introduce you with this align and aligned at. Okay, rest also you can use, but these two will be enough for our this whole lecture. And even so far, even my whole whatever I have written so far, all papers or books or sorry thesis whatever, so I used only this either align or at most equationary or aligned whatever. Okay, so you need not to worry about all the environment. So let us see how we can do this, how to write multiple equation or how to write a large equation in multiple lines. So what I have to do, again, I have to start some environment, begin a line, and I have to end that environment with end a line. And here I can refer to my, I can write my mathematical expressions, and here I have the label key. Okay, so since now we have a large equation, and we have to break that equation so that some of the part goes to the next line of your page. So to break the equation, okay, or line, we use this double slash we have to put. And for the purpose of the alignment, we will use this AND operator. Okay, so let us look at example first. Look at this. So I will... okay, let us look at this first, then I will, okay, so look at this. I want that my equation appear in this manner, okay, instead of this whole equation in one single line. So what I have, and note that this is a just one single equation. So there is one single number for this equation. So if I am, later on, I will explain one more environment, but let us look with this first. Begin a line. And a line, and then here again the label to refer to this equation. So what I have start with, I have to start with what A, then I have written rest of the things, x square plus 2 lambda plus 3x minus y. Then at this point I want to break it. So I have to break this, I have written here double slash, and before that I have written here no number. Okay, so why I have written this? Because with the, if we are using the align environment, then what it will do, it will produce the numbers for this line, this line, this line. But since we are writing one single equation, so instead we want that only the number appear as a for a whole equation, we have just one single number. So we will not put here in the last line, we will not put no number, but in rest of the lines I have written no number. Okay, and to break to the next lines, I have used after no number this slash. Okay, and here for the aligning, below the equal sign I have this plus sign, then plus sign, then plus sign, and for that I have written this and symbol. So just put this and symbol on the right side of that particular mathematical symbol along which you want this alignment. So just on the right side of this equal and this plus plus sign, I have written this and symbol, and you will be able, once you compile these all things, these things, you will be able to get this output. Here your single equation that is written in the multiple lines. Okay, let me introduce you one more thing, that I think this is more helpful for writing the single equation in multiple lines. So again, let me emphasize what I am doing. I have one single equation. Okay, this is a single equation. Equal to is appearing, for example, only at one place. Single equation I am writing in multiple lines. So single equation means there will be only one number for that equation. Okay, so for that, if you want to use the equation anyway, so here what I have done, begin equation and begin equation and correspondingly end equation, and inside that use this begin aligned and aligned. Okay, so if you have to use this aligned environment, then for the aligned environment you have to put that inside some another environment. For example, here's, for example, I have written it in the equation environment. Okay, so and then rest of, then you need not to put here slash no number, but I have written earlier. So this is, I think, more good to use for the single equation in multiple lines. Use this aligned environment inside this equation environment. So again, all the things are same. A is equal to rest of things, break that with this double slash, then next line and the next line and so on. Do not put this double slash on the right last line. Okay, and this and symbols you have to write for the aligning, so that you have this beautiful alignment. Here all these operators, they are appearing in just one single column. So this is how you can write, and when you will compile this, then your equation number that will appear just in the middle of this. Okay, if you use the earlier environment, then here, because what it will do, it will produce the numbers for all these things. So corresponding to this here will be number. So to omit that, I have written here no number, then here number, and this number is appearing now. Okay, so I think it is good to use this one. Okay, so but this aligned environment, that is which is written inside the equation environment, that is only for the situation when we have one equation in multiple lines. Suppose you have some multiple equation, for example, some linear system of equations. So for example, these are three equations, okay, and all you want to align, and you are writing in a single environment. Okay, so what you can do, you can we begin align and align, and inside that write these all equation x plus 2y plus z is equal to 0 and so then. And you see here I have written double slash, but I haven't written here no number, and because of that you are able to get the numbers for all the equations. Okay, if you want that, you want to skip, for example, this 15, then just put here no number. Okay, then 14 will come here, then 15 will come to the next. Okay, and so this is how we can use the align environment to write the multiple equation. Just start with begin align and end align, and inside that you can write your equations. And for example, here I want that my x, so you see what I have done. X is appearing just in one single column. So on the right side of x, I have written here and symbol. Okay, so alignment environment that is able to do the alignment at single place. There is some align at environment. I am not explaining here that, but with the help of that, you can get the alignment at multiple places also.
Oh, sir, excuse me.
Yes.
Sir, I'm not being able to understand this thing. A couple of seconds ago, you have taught us that by using the align command, we are actually allowed to write down equation. I mean, multiple line, single equation. Okay, but here you have used the align again, and but the equation is coming. 14, 15, 16 numbering. So it's not been clear.
Yeah. So I told that we are now trying to understand two things. One is that I have a single equation, and I have written that single equation in multiple lines. The second thing is that I have a system of equations. These three equations, I want to write that in a single environment. If you write, although you can use begin equation and equation separately, then you can check that how they are appearing. They will appear very far off places with a space between them. Okay, but if you want to write that system simultaneously, okay, let me show you okay. Let me show you the document.
So what is the basic difference?
Okay, look at this basically. Okay. Look okay. at it. Here, see how this equation, these three equations are appearing. Okay, so these are appearing one next to other. Means in the first line, first equation, then next line, then. So you are writing three equations simultaneously next to next. But if
sir,
you
in
use
equation number 2.2, there is also three equation, right? But yeah. it's only, one numbering. Equation number 2.2. But here, actually 2.7, 2.8, 2.9.
So that is what I told, that in the align environment, if you
okay,
want
no to... Number run, command.
No
okay,
number
okay.
command.
No number command. No number command. No number command. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Clear. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Okay, if you want, okay, so next is, suppose you want to sub-number the equation. So for example, I am saying that I have written the system of equation, and suppose if it is that, suppose instead of numbering 20, 21, 22, you just want like 20A, 20B, 20C, like that, then what you should do, you just use this, begin sub-equations and sub equations, and rest of the things right inside this. Rest of the things are same as I told you earlier, begin align, end align. So just use this environment, begin sub equation and end sub equation, and inside that right, begin align, end align, and you will be able to get this system of equations. Here your numbering is sub numbering 20A, 20B, 20C. So this is very simple, just next, suppose you want to write some equations side by side, some equations on here on the one side. So you used this begin page and you use this mini page environment yesterday. So what I have done here, I have written three equations on one side, three equations on the other side, and the numbering is appearing like A, B, C, D, E, F sub numbering. So what I have done, I have written begin sub equations and end sub equations. So because I want the sub numbering for all the equations, and then three equations on the left side, three equations on the right side. So I have created a mini page. So yesterday, you know what is how to create the mini page. So you have to write begin mini page and end mini page. And between that, you write the three equations which you want on the left side, for example. And then again start the second mini page and that mini page, and between that write the equation which you want on the right side.
Hello sir, I have a query in this.
Yeah.
Sir, yesterday we used in the mini page we have used 0.5 slash text width.
Yes.
And okay, here so we are using line width. Yeah, so what is the difference between these?
So basically, what the text is appearing on your that whole page, the width of that is the text width, and width of a single line, that is called the line width. So we will explain you later on, basically, in the there is one particular lecture on lengths, basically. There it will be explained that by default, what is the width, what is the unit of the line width or test width or 0.5 centimeter.
So what is the output of this example? Kindly show.
Thank you. Yeah, this one.
Okay, thank you so
much. Sir, sub-equation we should use within the equation environment, or it is a separate environment itself?
It is a separate environment. You have to start with the sub equation environment, and inside that you have to write the other equation environment, like a line environment, so that the you could number sub number those equations. Okay, outer environment should be begin sub equations. Okay, similarly there is one more thing. If you are writing this using this begin align environment, so again, if you want to omit the numbering of the way I introduced you earlier with equation star environment, you can also use align star environment. In the then you will not get the numbering of any of the equation. Okay, so if you want that you don't want to display the number of the equation, then just put align star and align star. And if you want to introduce inside the equation some short test, for example here I have written and, which is here a test, then what you can use the command short inter test. Okay, and in the curly bracket write that test, for example and here I used this command to give some space. Here I want this and here or here or here. Accordingly, you can adjust this horizontal space command inside that 1 centimeter. So you can adjust that, you can change this number, and you will see that how this the position of this and symbol is changing. So again, I have written here that if you want to use this facility, then you should write in your preamble this use package math tools command. Okay, I think this you can, I can skip for right now. If you want to write some equation in the box, then you can box that, right? For example, here I've written slash box. For example, if you are doing some derivation and the last result of derivation, generally we want to put, okay, we have proved this. Okay, then you can write slash boxed, and but in the curly bracket, write your math. Or if you have the multiple lines or equations, then just write slash boxed slash and inside that use this, for example here I use begin aligned, and outside we have the begin equation and end equation. Okay, in this whole box these all equations are coming. So whatever we have written earlier, all the things are same, just the new thing is that if you want to write something in the box, then use slash boxed. And in the curly bracket, write whatever equation you want to write. Okay, this is very important. Now, what I am, suppose you are writing this equation, for example. You are writing that x is equal to y plus z. If z is greater than 0, then what you have to write? Okay, so what we are doing here, basically, we are writing the test inside the equation. Okay, so how we can do that? I haven't numbered this, so I have written begin equation star and equation star, and inside that I have written x is equal to y plus z. Then I have to write if. So if you want to write some test inside the math, then you can use these two commands. One, you can use slash test inside the curly bracket, you write your that test, or you can use math rm. And inside the curly bracket, you write that your particular test you want to write. This is called math Roman. So Now look at the appearance of this if. So if you want to if you want your this symbol if appear in some mathematical Roman style, then you have to use the metro. Otherwise, it will simply appear like if simple test. Okay, and if you will not put any test, then it will appear just in the italic form. And along with that, note that here I am writing this quad before if. I have written this double quad, and after this after if also I have written double quad, so that I could get this spacing. I told you earlier that whenever we are writing something in the mathematics, then in math mode, then the spacing that get omitted. Okay, but here we want that if before and after if there is some finite space. So yesterday Dr. Sunil introduced you with the quad command. Quad or double quad, they can be used to introduce you the space. So we have here x is equal to pi plus z, and after that we have some finite space, then we have that symbol again, then finite space. Okay, if you will not
so can't we use h space instead of the q quad?
You can write.
Okay, thank you.
Whatever the ingredients which we are telling you, that you try with all these, start with simple, and maximum what happen, you will get the error. Okay, but you will be able to remove the errors. Don't worry.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is the difference between first and second? What's the difference between first and second case?
Okay. Look at this if. Are you able to see this if? One if I have written with the help of math rm command, right? And another I have written in the test using the test command. So look at the appearance. Generally, when we are writing something in the mathematics, then we want that our test, they also appear in some mathematical style, okay? Math Roman style. So if you want to appear your if, because these are some small things actually. If we are not aware with this math rm, then we will simply write if test if. Okay. So if, but if you want exactly to appear your things more beautiful, then I think you should use math rm command to write some test in along with some mathematical symbols.
Okay. So I think maybe I can point it out that math rm means that you will get the Roman font. Okay, so this if which is written, the first if that is written, that is in the Roman font, and the second if that is written, that will take the font of your original text, whatever original fonts you are using, which you are using to write your normal text, then this particular text will take that particular font, but MathRM will convert it into a Roman font, specifically Roman font. So that is the difference between the two.
Hello, sir.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Yeah. Okay, I have please. Two queries.
Okay.
Can I ask background? It here?
Yes, but your background music or sound is.
No, there is no background music from my side.
Okay. Maybe someone else.
Okay. So first query. Sometimes in mathematics, since I belongs to mathematics subject, okay. Sometimes in mathematics I have to write the two values of the function, f of x is equal to, and I have to put the curly bracket at the beginning, after equal sign at the beginning. How to do that?
That I will explain next. Means okay. And we will explain case and value.
Okay. And second, can you explain the equilibrium environment?
Which one?
Equation
array.
Yeah, yeah. It may be equation array. Yeah, yeah.
EQ and A double, right? A double array.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So I think I omitted that because I have written here basically not recommended. Okay. So look at this two. Please. Okay. Okay, so look at these two system. Look at these two things. One I have written using the equation array environment, and one I have written using the align environment, for example. Okay, So you can see that the one thing is that the spacing on both side of the equal sign, that is very large if you are using the equation array environment, but that is not the problem with the align environment. Second thing is the difference is that when we are doing the alignment in the align using when we are writing the using the align environment, then for the case of alignment, I need to use the one and sign. That I have written here on the left side of this your equal sign here. But when you are using the equation array environment, and if you want to do the alignment, for example, here we want that equal sign is all the equal assigned, they come in a single column, then I have to use the two and symbol, and one and I have to put on the one side and another on the right side of this. So we here in the equation array, we have to use the two and sign. And in the align, we have to use the single and sign. And the second one thing I want to share with you, which I also encountered many times, that when I am using some equation array and I am referring to that particular equation, which is for which I use the equation and array environment, then generally I get some error, some very arbitrary error. I am referring to the equation and it will say a section of that equation. Okay, so. Try to avoid this equation array environment. Use the align. That is my recommendation. Okay, and you can.
Yes, sir. Clear. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Still, I think we have to go a long way because still many. Although we have already 1 hour 30 minutes, but I hope that all of us are enjoying. Hello. Hello.
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. Next, one more thing I want to explain. Suppose you want to write something in the bold font inside the your equation. Okay. Then what you will do? For example, when in the mathematics, for example, or when we are writing some equation, we have to write the vector. So instead of putting these arrow symbols, we can use the font, bold font. Okay. So what you can do for the bold, one thing you can do the math BF, test BF. For example, I have used all the, look at this, the appearance of these all things. F is equal to force is equal to mass into acceleration. A, look at the appearance of A. In the first line, I have used math BF. Inside the curly bracket, I have written this F. Then for A, I have written test BF. So it is appearing like test. Okay, but if you want that it appear in the math form, some bold letter, specifically talking about some bold letter, then if you want this kind of A or italic form of this F, then what you should do, actually, you should use this one. What is, so look at this. But I have written inside the box, okay, M box command is used, and then two curly bracket. Inside the curly bracket, I have used bold math, and then again the curly bracket, because bold math, M box will take me to the test environment. So to write the math, I have to again write this dollars signs, and inside that write your symbol. So just follow this slash M box for writing F. Then curly bracket, bold math, then first curly bracket corresponding to this bold math, then dollar symbols, inside dollar symbol write your F, okay? And then close the curly bracket, first corresponding to bold math, and the next corresponding to the M box, okay? So you can use this bold math command, okay, which is written inside M box to write the bold font, or if you are not interested in making the things more complicated, then you can use the math BF or test BF. But now you have to decide what is your requirement, okay? And accordingly, you can proceed. Okay, so one more important thing now we are going to deal with, and that is the delimiters. So what is the meaning of that? This here we will deal with some bracket, okay, some boundary Okay, for example, suppose look at these expressions. Here I have written f inside x 2 square of that. Okay, here again I have written. So you may have f, and inside suppose you want to write, for example, x upon y. Okay, now although on your keyboard you can use write this small bracket just pressing the keys corresponding to these brackets, but in that case your bracket will be small in size. For example, here what I have written inside this bracket, that is going out of these brackets. Okay, to avoid that, we should use the command which I am introducing with you. So look at this example. I have written begin equation star, end equation star. Then I have written integral. So for the integral, the command is slash int. Then inside, then you have to the integrate exponential this. I have to put these brackets. Here I have simply put the small bracket on both sides. I haven't used the command. But in the next, what I have done, to put the bracket on the left side, this small, I have used this command, slash left, then opening. Okay, so you have to write slash left, then opening bracket, then I have written x raised to power a plus b, then I have written slash right, and then closing. So what is the benefit? With the help of this left and right, if you write this left and right before this small bracket, then your bracket will be scaled. Okay, means here we have a small the size of the bracket, that is small, but here it will scale according to your requirement, according to the requirement of your expression. Okay, so for example, look at this here. So what I told you, that use this left then command, then right, then your bracket. But whenever you are using this left and right commands for the opening and closing of the bracket, then one thing you have to take care that if you are using the left command to open the bracket, then you have to use the right command to close the bracket. Now look at this equation, for example, and look at this equation. Here, I have the equation which is in the two lines. In the one bracket is appearing in the first line, other bracket is appearing in the second line. So what I have done here, in the first line, I have written slash left, look at this, slash left, then closing bracket, opening bracket, then there is no bracket on this side. Okay, so, but in the LaTeX, if we are using these left, right commands, then in the same line, if we are using left, then we have to use the right. But since here we do not have any bracket on the right side to close in the first line, so what we will do, we will write slash right, and along with that we will put this dot symbol. Okay, so we will write slash right dot. Okay, so if we look at this side here, I haven't put, so this code will not work. So but here now when I switch to the right next line, in the next line I have the closing bracket, so slash right, then the bracket. Okay, but now here I have right, left, right bracket, then correspondingly on the left side I should have something. Okay, so I have written a slash left and that dot symbol. So this will only, this is the way you can use this left right command, that in the same line if you are using the left, then you have to write, use the right, and if there is no right bracket, for example, or left bracket, then simply write slash right slash left, and along with that put dot. So if you want to write the, for example, instead of this small bracket you have this square bracket, then put slash left this square bracket, it will scale the square bracket. If you have to put the brace bracket, then yesterday Dr. Sunil told you that this left this curly bracket, that is, has some special purpose. Okay, so you cannot write just slash left and curly bracket. So if you want to print it, you have to use the slash curly bracket or L brace, R brace kind of things.
Sir, excuse me.
Yes.
Sir, would you please be kind to explain again that dot thing after right?
Yes, yes.
In the code.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Let me show you one table actually.
Okay, sir.
Look at this table. Okay, so this will explain my all things what I want to convey. Look at first line. I have x upon y. On the both side, I have the square bracket. So I have written slash left. Then the bracket I want to put on the right side slash right. Then bracket I want to put. In the next case, I have the curly bracket only on the one side. On the right, left side, I do not have any curly bracket. So in that case, if you are using left right command to put the bracket, then and so on the right right side you have the curly bracket, you will put slash right, then your bracket for the then I told you that since curly symbol that is reserved for some particular purpose, so if you want to print this, then you have to write slash this curly here. If you put simple curly, then it will not work. Okay, so but on the other, on the left side, we do not have the curly bracket. So whenever you do not have that bracket on one side to accompany this right symbol, okay, we have a right command, we have to use the left command. And since we don't want here to put any bracket, so what we do along with this left, we will just put a dot. Okay, other, this is the way, because otherwise this will not work. Okay, so okay, so I hope I am clear now. Shamim.
Yes, sir. Okay. No, sir. Actually, on the previous slide, please. Yes, sir. I mean, here in the code, do not use code, not that one, but the simple code. Yes, sir. The right word side. Yes. On the second line, you have write down dot, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, here, on the next line, after left thing, again dot. Then next slide, please, sir. Next slide. The table next you have shown us. No, yes sir. Here again, after left, there is again dot. I'm just requesting it to you that, sir, why these dots are coming?
So, no, I have put this dot.
Sir, show him the output. Show him the output first.
Because we do not have any bracket on the one side. So, if you okay, let me show you the text studio then. So see, REFT. Look at this, x square plus y square, left, right. Okay, now suppose I do not want any bracket on the one side.
Okay, sir.
Then error, okay? Okay, so now what, and I don't want to write, then put a dot, then this error will not be there. Okay, so to avoid that error.
Okay, so just to remove the bracket on side, we could use that dot, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, if I want to actually remove the bracket on the both side, then the previous actually, yes. I mean, if I want to remove the bracket on the both sides, then
don't use this slash left bracket, right bracket, simply write.
Okay, sir.
Okay, there are some other way of putting the bracket. Look at this command, slash big big. So slash big command, that will put a bracket, slash big big, that will put a bracket, large bracket. If you are using these big commands, then you need not to write the way you have written here. On the left side, we have written left dot. Then here you need not to put now on the with the help of big command. But the problem is that these will not scale according to your requirement. Left command will scale the bracket according to your command. Depending upon the expression, it will increase or decrease the height of your that particular bracket. But these big commands, they will not be able to do so. So I recommend to use the left right commands, but take care of the left dot right dot if they are needed. Okay, similarly, if you want to put the bars kind of thing, then you can use this word, left word, right word. Okay, so if you want to so look at the word, okay, and then left word, okay, some small bar, and left this L word for the look at this, actually this one, okay, left word, right word, so L word. If you want two bars, so L, capital V here, capital V on the both sides. So again, make sure that if you are using left right, then on the, if there is no bracket on one side, then you have to put that dot. Okay, so I think this bar, so all these bar, you have to put bracket, square bracket, small bracket. You can look into the that KLaTeX or okay. So next important thing I am going to explain, how to write the matrices. So for the case of matrices, we have to use this we have to use this matrix environment, and but the matrix environment you have to write within some environment, for example here equation environment. Okay, so only then you will be able to write the matrix. Look at this matrix first. A is equal to, then I have this bracket and then matrix. So what I have written, I have started begin equation, correspondingly I have end equation. Then for the case of matrix, I start with begin, then curly bracket, we have written P matrix. So depending upon what are the bracket you have for the matrix, you want a square bracket, or you want a curly bracket, or you want this simple determinant, or double lines, or no bracket, you can use accordingly simple matrix, or P matrix, or V matrix, or capital B matrix, whatever. Okay, write those things. And for the case of like you have written here, first row A, then next column, to separate, to go to the next column, use AND symbol, then the next B, then next column, to switch to the next column, put first AND symbol, then next column. If you forget to put this AND symbol, for example, then C will also switch to the second column. Then put this double slash to move to the next line, then again first entry, then again AND symbol, second entry, and so on, and put AND symbols again, and then so on. So I think for
the Arvind sir, yeah. sorry to interrupt here, for the negative sign we are not using anything, are we?
Okay, maybe I forget, actually.
Okay fine.
And
okay,
sir, for A, capital A equal to, will it appear itself?
No, it will not appear. Actually, my motive was initially just to write the matrix. Matrix, so okay. That way, otherwise you have to use here A is equal to, after the begin equation you have to write A is equal to, then your matrix. Okay,
negative sign we have to introduce here, I think.
Yeah, so, this will minus C here, minus E here. Okay, minus G. Okay, so I think for the matrices, from this slide it is clear that depending upon what type of bracket you want to put, use accordingly P matrix, V matrix, or B matrix. Okay, so this is what is
sir, excuse me,
Yes.
Sir, how to write down actually that A dash?
It's A dash means prime.
Yes, prime.
So just put A dash or just A then slash prime.
Will you please be kind to write down on the text studio, please?
K letter. Okay. Let me show K letter. और इट विल नॉट ओके सॉरी ई आर आई इट्स ए कैप प्राइम और सिंपली ए देन फ्रॉम द योर कीवर्ड जस्ट पुट दैट prime sign.
Okay sir, excellent, thank you very much sir, thank you very much.
Okay, so this is all about the matrices, basically how we can put the determinant or square bracket or all that. Look at this this matrix. In this matrix again, this is a matrix of four columns and four rows. Only is that in the one of the column or rows I have these dot symbols. Okay, and these are the dots in the column side, these are the vertical dots, these are the diagonal dots. So in place of this entry, look at the code. Then I am, so this is the first element, then second column, then third column. So for the dots in column, you see dots, and for the vertical dots like this use v dot command, and for the diagonal dot like this T dots. So three dots will appear. Okay, C dots, B dots, or B dots. You can use these kind of command. Rest of the things are again same. Okay, and you will be able to get this matrix.
Sir, the number of dots will be three only, right?
Yeah, this C dots. Okay, this is what one of the person was asking, that how to write this kind of expression, fx is equal to, then some case depending upon the condition, if x is even then this or this. Okay, so what you can do here, you can use the case environment. So start again, but case environment you have to write inside some math environment. For example, here begin equation, this is just one single equation. So begin equation, then write your f of x is equal to, then start the case environment, begin case, cases. You have to write as such what I have written here. Begin case and correspondingly end cases, and inside now first row xy2, then I have written this next, and then the rest of things, if then some space I have given, and then rest of things. Then to move to the next line, use this double slash and then write rest of things, and for this proper alignment, this this will play the role. Okay, so with the help of the case environment, we can use the mathematical expression which involve the cases. Okay, we are left with the theorems. So for the case of theorem, for example, especially in the mathematics, we used to write theorem 2.1, correspondingly we had the proof, Gödel, then remarks and definitions. For that we can define this environment, begin theorem, end theorem. So for the case of theorem, but you should have this package what I have written earlier. So how to write the theorem, let us try to understand this. In the preamble you have to write this command, new theorem. Then you have to write two curly bracket. In the first curly bracket I have written here some name, and here I have written something called output. Now let us try to understand what is the meaning of this thing. This kind of command that can be used to write the theorem, that can be used to write the definition or corollary or anything. Okay, for example, look at this. Here I have written theorem. Here I have written corollary. Here definitions. So what you want here, theorem or corollary or definition or lemma, those kind of those words, they will appear here as a output. And here in the name, so for the theorem you have to separately write this line. For the corollary you have to write a line like this separately and so on. So that name, for example, this one, I have written some theorem here, like theorem 7.1. So I have to write begin theorem and theorem. So that name here in the first curly bracket, it is not necessary that if you're writing the theorem, then here in the first curly bracket, you put the theorem name. You can put here anything, THM, for example. But make sure that if you are writing in the new theorem line here, THM, then same thing you have to write here. So better to write the meaningful thing. So, but don't write the same name. So I have written, used here, small t. Okay, so begin theorem and theorem, and write your theorem details here, and rest of the things, they will be. So with the help of this, you will be able to get theorem 7.1 and so on. And again, if you want to start the numbering like theorem 1, theorem 2 of your document, then you need not to use, for example, as I told earlier, if you want to number the equation within the sections, then in the preamble, you have to write the number within an equation section. Similarly, in the theorem line, new theorem command, if you put in the square bracket at the end section, then your theorems will be numbered according to your sections. And otherwise, if you omit this, then it will be numbered as per the flow of document 1, 2, 3, like that. Okay. So, and you can also give the optional name to the theorem. Just in the curly bracket, put your name which you want to appear. This is an optional thing, and you can get the theorem like this. Okay, similarly, if you want to write the corollary or something, then begin corollary and corollary. Then now you have to put a separate line for this in the preamble. New theorem again, but now in the second curly bracket, because in the output here, now you want the corollary. Okay, so that word you have to write here. Okay, and here you have to write just what you want to write here, begin corollary and corollary. Okay, and if you want that, this is the corollary corresponding to the theorem before which you have written. For example, here, here I have written 2.1 theorem. Then 2.1.1 means this corollary is corresponds to this theorem. Then what I have to do in the preamble, just here we are defining the new theorem command for the corollary. You have to write here theorem, TH, which theorem name, which is written in the theorem line in the first curly bracket. That name you have to put here. Look at this. Or this one, this name you have to put, okay, in the preamble. Let me show you actually the like this. These all things are written here in the preamble. New theorem, theorem and section, corollary theorems, lemmas or remarks or whatever you want. For the proof also we can use, proof is already defined basically. Look at this, begin proof and proof. And proof, whenever we prove something, then we use to write hence proved. And so for the case of the proof environment, this symbol generally comes automatically square bracket. If you want something else in place of the square bracket, for example, here I have written black square, then in the preamble just write renew command QED symbol, and then in the curly bracket within this dollar sign write black square. If you are not putting this command in the preamble, then you will get here, instead of this black square, you will simply get a square without simple square. Okay, these are some small things which I think I already covered many of things. If you want the For example, look at this x1, x2, xn. Then here I have the dots. Now, sometimes what happens that if you want to put three dot, you just click on your this keyboard and just put three dot manually. But instead of that, if you write x1, x2, then write l dot command. Then look at the beauty how it is appearing. Just after this comma, in the same line, these three dots are appearing. But if you are not using this l dot command, for example, then they will not look good basically. So you can try all this. For example, here look at this. Look at this thing and this thing. Here for putting the dot, I just put simple. We use the keyboard dot dot dot. But if you want to put use if you use the command, then appearance will be very nice. Okay, L dots and C dot for single. So take care of this. If you are using, if you want to put single dot, then C dot. If you want to put three dot, then C dots. Same is for the L. So take care of this S basically. Similarly, look at this this beautiful example. Dot product of two vectors A dot B. So if you want that dot symbol appear at the proper place, so write like A, then write this C dot, and then your next. Okay. Otherwise, your dot symbol that will appear very close to these A and B symbols. So that is, these are very small things. So I think that is. Then spacing, I told you earlier that we can use the quad or double quad kind of thing for the spacing. If you will not use, then for example, look at this. How then this letter is coming along with this 0 and y. Okay, so to put the space, you should use quad or double quad kind of thing. Okay, so for the summations, you can use this slash sum command. For the product, you can use the slash prod. These things I explained for the summation, how to write the fractions. Multi-line, suppose you have some summation and you are doing the summation over things, and these are appearing along with some kind of conditions. Okay, many times we use to use this. So what you have to do, you have to use this sub stack command. Okay, so what you do, write sum underscore, then in the underscore rest of the things slash sub stack, and then inside that sub stack. So here in the below the sum, there are two lines. One is I odd, put that in one curly bracket. Then in the next curly bracket, so put double slash, that will move to the next line. And you will put the information corresponding to the next line. E less than equal to, this is the command corresponding to less than equal to. Okay, so sub stack command that can be used to write the multi-line limits basically. This I already explained you. If you want to put the single integral, then slash int, double integral, double int, triple integral, triple int. If you want to put a integral over the closed path, then slash o int. If you want to put the integral over the, you have a double integral or closed surface, for example, then you put double I and T. Before that, just put O. Okay, then you will get the integral over the closed path. Okay. Okay, this is one more important thing. I think we should take some time at this. Suppose you are writing some physical quantity and you are writing the units. Now look at this. I have written here the speed of light is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So here I simply write like, for example, meter, then I have written here second cap minus 1. But if you want to appear in the math Roman, then meter per second, you have to write like this math RM. Then you use this command. And also for the proper some small space between this your number and this unit, you can use this dash comma. This will produce a thin space. For example, if you are writing some equations, then at the end of equation, you used to put comma. Sometimes what happens that comma just joins your end of the equation. So put some small. So if you want to put some small space, then you can use this slash comma to, and you can introduce some and some thin space basically. And what I told you in the very beginning of this lecture, if you want to put the units in some beautiful manner, then you can use this SI units package. And for so if you are, for example, see I have written here 9.8 meter per second square. Then what I have to like this nine. Suppose I want to write 9.8 meter per second square. So I have to use this one slash SI, then 9.8, then in the curly bracket write rest of the things, and your you will see that your things will appear very beautiful. So it is up to you, but at least use this math rm commands for writing the unit, and use this command to put a thin space between the physical, between the number and the units. Okay, so we are almost so these are one few more thing. If you want to overline, then just put slash overline and m minus 1, for example here. If you want to put a brace over some symbols, then put use slash brace, and then in the curly bracket write rest of the things. And over the brace, if you want to write something, then use this subscript commands. Okay, then stacking in the mathematics, this is important. So for the stacking, what you can do, use this stack rl command, stack rl, then two curly brackets inside this, write what you want to write on the upper side, and then the lower one that will come here. For example, look at this A, then arrow, on the arrow I have seen some all A. So I have written A, then stack RL, then in the first curly bracket I have A, in the next curly bracket I have arrow, and that's B. Similarly, this I already explained you how to write this subscript, superscript, and you can use this stack RL, and the chemistry people can use this to write their reactions actually. This is the last thing of the lecture, I think. Suppose you are writing some paper in the two column environment, okay? Then, and if your equation is not able to fit properly, for example, look at this, my equation is going out of the page or out of the column. This here equation is just going into the second column, okay? So what you can do, either you can break this equation, you can, you whatever environment I discuss so far, use those environments, use the breaks slash slash to at the proper place so that your equation fits to the fit in a single column. Otherwise, I am just you can use one this command, begin strip, end strip, and inside that use align environment. So what it will do basically, it will fit your it will switch from the two column to the single column, and it will fit your equation into the whole page with help of the begin strip, end strip command. And otherwise, if you have a single equation, if you want to resize that equation, maybe the appear, you may lost the appearance of that equation, but you can also use this command, resize box. Okay, so but if you want to use this strip environment, then you have to use this use package, Qt and math tools. Okay, Qt and math tool package, then you can use this strip environment. Okay, so I think now I am end up with my today's lecture. These are some references. If you want to understand more about the mathematics, then you can look at the Wikipedia, this specially dedicated to LaTeX. This is very beautiful book, LaTeX in 24 hours. There are two chapters on the equations, and then this is again one book, and this is some site where you can put your queries, or you can see the question of different pupils, and you will be able to get many new things. Okay, so I think with this, I am end up with this lecture. So this, okay, so any question?
Sir, I mean, very cordial thanks to you for such an informative session, first of all. And you have explained so excellently that we will have very little query. But sir, in the lunch gap, I mean, I do want to practice. So would you please be kind to share this PPT in the group or yes. through email so that
yeah,
you can
yeah, yeah.
practice?
Okay. Yes. Okay. Now I will. Thank okay. So yeah. So I will share the PPT and tech file as well and assignment also. Okay. That we are going to meet.
Sir. Okay. So that would be better for me because we are the first. Learner, first time learning LaTeX.
Yes, yes.
If you provide us PPT, then it would be better to.
Yeah, I will just now. I will send the PPT and I will also share the tag file so that you could look into the codes of how they are written. Okay, but because my PPTs are prepared using the Beamer, so sometimes some of the things they get different as when we are using Beamer class or Article class. So that you have to take care, but you can still look into the codes from the PPT.
For command, particularly for command, using command, we need.
Yeah, yeah.
So there are large number of commands.
Yes, yes. So you will.
You are going to share the text file as well, right, sir?
Yes, I will share that.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. Any other questions?
Sir, how to put a dot like we write in when we write derivative in short form we put x dot. So yeah. How to write that? Sir?
You mean a dot over x? That is what you are asking.
Yes.
Yes.
You can slash write backslash dot and then in the braces you can write x.
Look at this slash dot, and in the bracket you.
Thank you, sir.
So I think we can meet after 20 minutes, or right? Let us meet at 12:10. Okay. For the I will share the tutorial. We will take only I think 1 hour tutorial or so, and then we will take a lunch break. But I think it is important that we will. Try to write at least one or two equations in the tutorial session. Okay, rest of things you can do at home. Okay, but it is important that we do some practice actually. So let us meet at 12:10.
So do we have to join at the link for the specified group?
Yeah, for the specific groups as mentioned in the PDF okay. file.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, sir, I have forwarded that also. Okay, so just look, join your groups. Okay, thank you all.